To divide rational expressions, we write the division problem as the multiplication problem by multiplying by the reciprocal of the divisor with the reciprocal of this fraction here. So to do this, the first fraction stays the same. We'll have 4x squared minus 28x minus 32 all over 2x squared minus 12x minus 14. And now we'll change the division to multiplication. And now for the reciprocal of our divisor, the numerator is going to be 3x squared minus 20x minus 7, and the denominator is going to be x squared minus 6x minus 16. So to determine the reciprocal of a fraction, you could think of just flipping the fraction over. And now before we multiply, we do want to simplify out all the common factors between the numerators and denominators that would simplify to 1, but before we do this, we do have to factor everything. So we can't start simplifying, for example, this 4x squared and this 2x squared, because we cannot simplify across addition or subtraction. So for the next step, we'll factor all of the numerators and denominators. Remember, the first step in factoring is to factor out the greatest common factor. So looking at this numerator here, we can factor out a factor of 4 that would leave us with x squared minus 7x minus 8. In the next step, we'll try to factor this again. And notice this denominator has a common factor of 2, so if we factor 2 out, we're left with x squared minus 6x minus 7. It is important that we don't forget the first step in factoring is to factor out the greatest common factor. Notice here there are no common factors, so if this factors, it'll factor into two binomial factors, where the first terms of our factors must come from 3x squared, which would be 3x and x. And then we want to place the factors of negative 7 into the second positions so that the sum of the inner product and outer product would be equal to negative 20x. So notice if we put minus 7 here, the outer product would be negative 21x. And if we use a negative 7 here, we have to use a positive 1 here. So negative 21x plus 1x does equal negative 20x. So this is factored correctly. Then for our denominator here, we have x and x. And now we want the factors of negative 16 that add to negative 6, which would be negative 8 and positive 2. So we have x minus 8, x plus 2. But going back to this first fraction, we do need to try to factor this again. So we still have this factor of 4. And then if this factors into two binomial factors, where the first terms would be the factors of x squared, which are x and x. And now we want the factors of negative 8 that add to negative 7. That would be negative 8 and positive 1. And then for the denominator, the factors of x squared again. And the second positions come from the factors of negative 7 that add to negative 6. That would be negative 7 and positive 1. Second fraction stays the same. 3x plus 1 times the quantity x minus 7, and we have x minus 8 times x plus 2. So every time we have a common factor between the numerator and denominator, it's going to simplify to 1. So for example, here we have x minus 8 over x minus 8. Here we have x plus 1 over x plus 1. These are all simplifying to 1s, and we also have an x minus 7 over x minus 7. And there is one last thing we can do. Notice 4 and 2 share a common factor of 2. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 2 2's and 4. Now we can multiply knowing our product will be in simplest form. The numerator is 2 times the quantity 3x plus 1. And the denominator is just a factor of x plus 2. And that's it for this problem. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.